Hey everybody, John Sposato here from the Arizona Home Group at Keller Williams Snoring Living. Hope your 2020 is starting off with a bang. In a minute here, I'm going to talk a little bit about the numbers and how the year ended up. It was quite amazing, actually. But first, I want to remind you really quickly of our Save the Date below of our annual spring charity raffle. It is for the Care Fund benefit. We'll be doing our happy hour at the Thirsty Lion. For those of you who came last year, we had a great turnout. Lots of fabulous prizes and gifts to bid on, and for a great cause, the Care Fund. More information to come later in a month and also in February, but just wanted to give you that date. It's March 26th. It's a Thursday. Again, at Tempe Marketplace, the Thirsty Lion, between 5 and 8 p.m. So put it on your calendar. We hope to see you. Anyway, so let's talk about the market and how 2019 ended up in Phoenix, the housing market, and it actually ended up being number one in the country. In late December, I sent you out an article that showed that Phoenix's houses appreciated 6% on average over the year versus 3.2% in the U.S., so almost doubling the U.S. average, putting us at number one. But even more so, the rental market actually, rents went up 6.8% last year versus an average of 3.1 in the U.S. So again, Phoenix is a hot market, the number one market in the country last year. People are coming here in droves, whether they're buying or renting or job transfers or whatever. They are coming, and that's not going to stop anytime soon. Let's take a look at how that looked at the numbers. So this is the total number of units that closed year over year. So 2018 versus 2019, you can see there was about almost 3,500 more homes that closed last year versus the year before. And that's up 4.6% year over year. So that's a lot of units extra that closed. Let's look at the median home price in Maricopa County. So we're at $300,000 for the median home price. It's the highest it's ever been. Looking at last year in January, it was $272,000. So that's up 9.6 year over year appreciation on the median home price. Taking a look at the Crawford report, I show you our little speedometers here, and again, more green means heavily towards the sellers, less inventory. It's definitely more of a seller's market. We went from 196 to 208. So again, as the numbers increase and there's more green, there's less homes for sale, you can see supply is down and demand is up. So again, supporting that the market is really hot and people are coming in droves. Let's look at the total listings that are under contract right now. So these are all the buyers that are writing contracts out there. We've got almost 7,400 homes that are currently under contract, and that is 19% above where we were last year at this time. So we've already out of the gates started out with a lot of buyers out there. There's multiple offers on different properties that are really good. So definitely a lot of activity. How's the effect having on our inventory? Well, let's take a look. Things continue to decrease. Just over 11,200 homes currently for sale in the MLS, and that is actually down 34% year over year. 34% less homes today than there were a year ago. That's amazing. And that's not being helped by new inventory coming to the market. I showed you this graph a couple of months ago. This is weekly tracking of new homes that are coming to the market every week. You can see at the end of the year, towards December, towards the holidays, things slowed down, but they haven't really picked up so much. They did the first week of January, but then dropped off precipitately. Last week, we only had like 538 homes to the market, brand new homes to the market. That is really low. Last year at that week, this week, we had over 2,400. So that is not a good pace. If we take a look at where that would end up, this was January of 2019 versus January of this year. Okay, so more than halfway through the market, we have one third the homes, new homes coming to the market than we were last year in January. So again, no new inventory to support all that buyer activity. It's gonna be a crazy spring, folks, trust me. So if you're a seller and you're looking to go on the market right now, there's not much inventory, so your homes are selling really quickly and for top dollar. And if you're a buyer, we want to help you get in there. Let's jump into the market before things spiral completely out of control over the next year or so. Let's help you get into a new home. So feel free to reach out. So from the entire Arizona Home Group, we're looking forward to helping you find a new home or get your home sold. Have a fantastic January, and we'll see you next month. Take care.